Good morning, children. Zero Pile of History. As you can hear, I am sick, and so I'm home today. I do not have the run away. I don't have the run away today. It doesn't feel like it, though. I haven't had a beer. It's been sniffling and coughing and sneezing for about 3 or 4 days. So. Anyway, today we're going to talk about... angles of a triangle, so let's get right to it. Here's a fact that you probably already know. The angles of a triangle, so the ones inside, say, this triangle, they all add up to 180 degrees. You probably already knew that. So, let's take a look at this first problem here. The measure of angle 2 is 103, and the measure of angle 3 is 51. Well, what is the measure of angle 4? This angle over here. Well, we can figure that out by doing this. Subtract 103 and 51 from 180. So 180 minus, let's see, that's 154. That would give us 26, right? So this is 26. And then we know that this is a linear pair. So subtract 26 from 180. So the answer is 154. Are those two related? Let's take a look. It looks like this value here is the sum of this value and this value. How can that be? Well, angles of a triangle add up to 180. So, the measure of angle 1 plus the measure of angle 2 plus the measure of angle 3 equals, I ran out of room. Maybe just read. It's a little bit of what it says. Here, I'll put it right there like that. Measure angle 1 plus measure angle 2 plus measure angle 3 equals 180 degrees, correct? So these three is 180 degrees, okay. But we also know that these two equals 180 degrees. So the measure of angle 4 plus the measure of angle 1 is also 180 degrees. So what do we have in common here between these two equations? They both equal 180 degrees. We have a measure of angle 1 right here. So if we were to subtract those, what are we left with? Look at that. Measure of angle 2 plus the measure of angle 3 equals the measure of angle 4. These are what we call, when we have a figure like this, this is what we call the remote angles. These two right here. And this is an external of a triangle. This is the external angle of a triangle. So when you take one side and you extend a ray out like this, you have an external angle. And it is equal to the sum of the remote angles. These two right here. So that's what you need. So that's what you will use to get through these problems here. And I just showed you how to do those. Here's another figure, and here we've got a few choices. Here's a linear pair. Here's a linear pair. These three add up to 180 then as well. And then of course we have a triangle right here, so these three add up to be 180. So let's do one of these. How about number 6? The measure of angle 4 is 126. The measure of angle 6 is 54. What's the measure of angle 2? Okay, well, here's a linear pair. So, 180 minus 126, let's see, that's 54. And if these two are 54, then angle 2 has to be, let's see, 54, 54 is 108. So, 180 minus 108 is 72. And that's how you get that stuff. All right. Stuff down here. That's... Alright, step number 9. Measure of angle 1 is 4. Angle 2 is 7. Measure angle 3 is 9. That is 4. Well, those are all expressions. But I know that they all added to 180, so I can just add them all together. 7. All combined, let's see, that's 16 feet. So this should be 20. And then minus 4, so this will be 24. Oh, nope, what did I forget? Let's start over. We got 4 times P, that's 4P. 4 times 26 is 104. There we go. Then we're going to subtract this 4, so this will be. Let's see, and then this 16 feet is left. Okay, so 20 feet equals 80. So P is 4. Measure of angle 4. Oh, we can find that out. Well, we can find these measures. If P is 4, then this is 28. This is 36 minus 4, which is 32. And this is, let's see, 16 plus 26 is 42. Plus 104, okay, yeah, that's 36, no, 16 plus 104, 16 plus 104 is 100, and that adds up, that's 50, that's 60, 120, 180, there we go, yeah, so P is 4, well, that was fun, wasn't it? Measure of angle 4, well, if this is 120, then this has to be 60. There we go. Pays to write things down instead of doing them in your head, doesn't it? Your teachers make you seem sometimes. All right, let's go and see what's down here. I know there's some fun. Oh, that's it. These things are fun. All right, let's take a look at this. Find the measure of each numbered angle. Okay, wait, let's see. AB is perpendicular to BC, so I'm going to make this line right there. And then the measure angle 10 is 64, so this is 64 degrees. Measure angle 6 is 57. And the measure angle D is 41. Alright, let's find all the rest. Well, this is 64 right here. So, and I know the rest of this whole angle is 90 degrees right here. So I'm going to just subtract 64 from 90. Gives me 26 degrees. Okay. Also, I know that angles 2, 6, and 10 make up a triangle, so 180 minus these two will give me So 180 minus, let's see, that's 121. Yeah, 180 minus 121, that's 59 degrees. So if that's 59 degrees, then I know, let's see, this is a linear pair, so this bit up here, let's see, that's 121. And here's another triangle, so 121 and 41 is 162. So that leaves, let's see, 18. And then this is a vertical right here, so there's 21. And then, well, you know what? I'm going to use some new knowledge. I know that this right here is an external angle to this triangle, triangle BEC. So if this is an external angle to the other two, so I know that 59 equals the sum of 26 plus this. So let's see, 59 minus 26, that leaves me. There. And these are some others. P is parallel to Q. So those two are parallel. Alright, that means we can get some more negative. Yeah. Let's see. That's all we have. Oh, here, this is 90 degrees. Let's see, any vertical angles here? Well, I know that these two. Ah, here's another linear pair, 144. 180 minus 144, 36. And then here's a triangle. 36 and 68. That's 104. So 108 minus 144. 76. And then here's a vertical angle, that's 36. Can I get the end? Yeah, but here's a linear pair. 164, let's see, that leaves 16 there. And then I can get G, let's see, 16 and 90 is 106. So that leaves 74 for this much. And then, let's see, all these three need to add up to 180. So 36 and 74 is 210. So this is 74. Yes, that's, yeah, these two add up to that. Alrighty. Where do we go next? How do we get all the way up here? Well, these lines are parallel, don't forget. So, let's see. This and this are an alternate interior angles. Okay, let's see. If that's 144, well, then this much must be 36, and this is also 36. Let's see, 54 and 36 is 80, is 90. So this is 90 degrees. Let's see, all that's left is angle D. Well, look, they're both the same. They're both the same. So they are. They're both the same, so they're congruent. So 144 divided by 2, that's 72. Is that all the angles that we have? Let's see. Yep. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. All right, these last few here. Let's see, give the measures of two angles of a triangle, determine whether the triangle is acute or angular obtuse. Okay. Here's two of the measures. What's left? Well, let's see, that's 80, 91, so that leaves 89 degrees. So is this acute? Yes, it is acute. No angle is greater. This is almost a right angle, but it's not quite, so this is. And 58, that adds up to be 80, that's 90. Oh, so this is 90. Aha, so this is a right triangle. Right triangle. Now these two right here, let's see this one. 25 and 20, that's just 45. So that leaves 135 degrees for that last angle. So this is right. Alright, there's one of each for you. And this concludes the angles of the triangle worksheet.